Welcome everyone. Today I want to show you how to replace the battery on the Flume 2 smart water sensor. I've been using the Flume to monitor my house's water usage and check for leaks for about 10 months now, and I've received my first low battery warning today. So here we are in the app, and at the top it says that your water sensor batteries are low and push here to fix. And from the link in the Flume app, you're redirected to this article on the Flume website about what to do when your batteries are low. So basically, if you look down here, there's a link down here to purchase the Flume specific batteries. So as you can see here, this is a bit of a special 3.3 volt battery that Flume provides you. I ordered mine about a week ago and it's here now. So in the rest of this video, I'm going to show you how to install that into your Flume water sensor. All right, so here's a good look at the Flume battery that I received. On the right side is the gold contact and this plastic housing. And then for the next steps, we just need to retrieve the Flume water sensor from the water meter in the yard, bring it inside, clean it up, and install the battery. So let's head out there and do that next. All right, so let's make our way over to the water meter. And there's our Flume. So I've had some ants protecting everything for me, which is nice. So first let's take a picture. So I think this is just to help us remember how we had it set up before. So now let's slip the Flume off the water meter without taking any ants with us. There's our Flume. Oh, look at all the ants all over my hands, that's wonderful. So now I've upset the ants, let's bring the Flume inside without them and do part two. All right, so now we have the Flume safely inside the house with hopefully 100% less ants on it. And we just need to clean this up now to make sure that when we open up the lid that no dirt or water or anything like that enters. Oh, there's a little ant friend right there. But fortunately they didn't bite me. So these are friendly ants, I guess. Just doing their thing in the yard. So it's probably about as good as we're gonna get it. So we're gonna pop this lid open now. Oh, more ant friends, okay. How bad are we? All right, so as a testament to the waterproofing, there's no ants on the actual inside, at least not yet, but soon there will be. So we need to just use this ribbon to pop the battery out for the existing one. All right, so now that's out. Just gonna make note of where the contacts are. So now that we have this open, this reminds me that I think I've read in the past that you can actually install a second one of these batteries for another, I guess, $19 and double your battery life. Or I don't know if one acts as a backup for the other, but something you can look into if you want, but I didn't think ahead. So back to just the original battery configuration. So there's a plus and minus sign for positive and negative. Just match those up on your batteries like so. And I guess if you've done everything correctly, that green light should flash. All right, so now that I've successfully relocated all of my ant friends back into the yard, I can safely close back up the lid. Make sure that's firmly closed. We want a nice watertight seal again. And according to the instructions, since we've listened for that nice click, we know we're sealed. So now that we've closed the Flume sensor back up, we can reattach this to the outside water meter and perform recalibration. So let's head over there now. All right, so hopefully my water meter ants have moved on to make this a little bit less tricky to do. So before you attach your Flume back into the water sensor, make note of how you had it set up in your previous photo. This is the top, and I know this because I took a picture, and also the bottom has a sticker where it says bottom. All right, so we'll just go ahead and take the rubber straps from the Flume water sensor and attach that around the body of the water meter. So the Flume smart sensor now appears to be attached firmly next to the water meter body. So now we'll head into the app and perform recalibration. All right, so now we're back here in the Flume app. We should be able to go into this hamburger menu in the top left and head under settings. And then under other troubleshooting, we can click on recalibrate water sensor and continue. So now we have to go ahead and run a stream of water from one of our faucets. So I'll go run a tub. Okay, so we have a success. And now that we've recalibrated, the battery warning has gone away from the top of the screen, which is great. All right, so that's all you need to do to change the battery in your Flume 2 water meter sensor. That was not too bad. And like I said, it lasted me for about 10 months and I've been really happy with the Flume in that time. If you have any questions on my experiences in those 10 months using the Flume 2 water meter sensor, I'll be glad to answer them in the comments section down below. If you found this video helpful, please click on the like button down below and consider subscribing to my channel for more great tech reviews. Thanks for watching.